Hello and welcome back to the final episode of Chillin Buildin for this Build the Faction HQ. You're joining me here in the office that I have constructed for myself, and the observant of you out there might have also noticed that we're in space. Yeah. Basically, I was working on the base earlier in the week and then this started happening. Basically getting errors every few steps that I took trying to build the base. Anyway, it turned out that all the changes that Elyon had made kind of broke the server. So, yeah, it made it pretty impossible to actually do anything on there. Anyway, the server, as a result of that, has now been wiped. And everything that was on there is now gone. Including my base, all the ships, everything. The server's been completely wiped. And we'll be coming back for a brand new season on the world server that we'll be covering at some point. Anyway, I did blueprint the base, and while I did try and spawn it down on Omicron, the flattest starter planet out there, couldn't actually get it to sit anywhere on Omicron. And I'll explain why I think that is later. But first, let me just take you around the new stuff, the stuff that I've done to the base. So, this is my office, basically. I got my little desk here, welcoming people as they come in. Position myself behind my desk. Yeah, there you go. And then, armed intruders. I've got a little panic button over here, so I can flip that. And that brings these two sentry guns out from hiding. Also, you know, if faction member says something that I don't particularly like, I can always flip that switch and shoot them. What else have I got in here? Some medi stuff. O2. I've got a constructor buried in the wall there, and obviously I've got a entrance to the landing pad which I've parked my fabled nightshade on. So that's my office pretty much in a nutshell. Oh, I have got my secret room back here. Okay, so I might code lock these doors, for example. Got some storage in here. The core is in here as well, as you've probably just seen. But yeah, that is the office. Quite like that. It's quite good. The other thing that I've done as well is, I haven't done this room actually. I've done the hospital though. Let me just take you down to see that through the bar, because, you know, you're in the bar, you will then end up in hospital. It's a pirate base, right? So yeah, here we are. This is the hospital, parking as per everything else in the base, pretty much. So there is roof access from the hospital. I think I showed you this before, but you could park a small CV up here and have direct access down to the hospital, which is basically full of some beds. So there's a ward, some labs, some scanners, and an operating theater, obviously. There you go, the hospital. Pretty straightforward, pretty simple, nothing fancy. But the other thing that I've done is a little bit more work on the roof, just to give it a little bit more life. Some more piping and things like that, a bit more texturing. I've sort of planted a load of CVs on the roof here so you can see what it kind of looks like in full flow, as it were. But that is pretty much it. There is one other thing that I did to the base, and I'm going to show you guys that now. And this is the last bit of space that I had in the base that I asked you guys what I could do with. So Static Air came up with a great idea, and this is what I did. Thank you. here it is in all of its finery. We're next to the house that I built in a previous episode. Put a couple of SVs around just to give it a little bit of life. But yeah, essentially what I've done is I've gone from a sort of like promenade type thing with some shop fronts. We got guns, chief supplies, prize parts. Yeah, they've all got little back rooms with storage containers in them and things like that. And yeah, I've left one empty as well. Just it's not filled yet. It's a nice VIP parking spot for someone visiting the casino. Coming to the casino here. Hand over any weapons. You come through, it's very yellow in here, I'll just warn you now. Got a bar, got some gambling machines. I know they're just deco blocks, but they're gambling machines to me. Got a staff only with a sentry gun, gold storage. Some more gambling machines and some tables, basically. Blackjack and poker tables. And of course a restroom. That's the casino. I decorated it quite in bright colours so it stands out, because, you know, casino wants to attract patrons, I guess. It's got a car park and it's got a dodgy underground room over here for shady dealings. Little restaurant quarter on top here with a Whole Foods style kitchen linking back to the garden, the greenhouses, which we've seen before. So yeah, that's pretty much it. Had a lot of fun with the textures, as you can see. I wanted to do something on the top to make it stand out, so multicolored lights and reflective surfaces and weird stuff going on up there. But these are all LCD screens here, the casino and dollar signs. So a little trade sector, casino sector to finish the base off. And there we are. That is pretty much it. I'm not going to do anything more to this base because, like I said, server's wiped now, so we're going to be busy starting again, doing a fresh start on the wall server and fighting our way back into space, back into battle with the wolves and all the other factions on the server, hopefully. Yes, they are all sentry guns along this wall. But yeah, I put this base on the workshop so you can download it. But like I said, you might have some trouble actually spawning it in, because a lot of this, I think the reason I had trouble spawning it in is because basically the underside of the base, which of course was buried underground, you didn't have to look at it, it wasn't there, but I've had to chop off the tunnel that I had that was here in the bunker, that was going deep into the ground. I've had to chop that off because it was quite a lot under the base. But I think what you might need to do if you want to spawn this in is essentially square all of this off on the underside and have a flat base foundation for it to all sit on. So see, a lot of this is just support pillars and things like that from where it was built, actually on the ground on Shard. Well, Shard doesn't exist on any server apart from the wall server, so you're not going to be able to find anywhere that's going to fit this base like a glove where it was built, basically. Disco floor. So yes, if you do want to use this base, then I suspect you're going to have to do a little bit of extra work on it yourself, I'm afraid. I would do it, but I don't have the time, unfortunately. I've got to draw a line in the sand in this one. I've done as much as I can. I'm not going to be available really to square that off on the underside, but everything on the top is good to go. So if you do get some use out of it, that's great. Let me know. I'd be really interested to hear. There we are. Oh yeah, those are the other thing as well. I did the induction center. I don't think I showed you this. So this is in the front, the induction center. New members come in here, get instructed to turn left, given the faction rules. To learn, to memorize. They can heal, they can top up oxygen, they can equip armor and repair their starting kit. Add armor mods, they can equip some weapons and ammo. And then they're given the Syndicate marker. Show no mercy. And from here they can head over to faction comms, which we saw in a previous episode, which is where they can get their initial missions and things like that from. But yeah, that's pretty much it. The only other thing is this lounge I did up here. It's just deco to fill the space, essentially. I'm trying to think if there's anything else that I've forgotten, but I don't think there is. And I could spend all day just trying to fill and pad, but I'm going to end it there, I think. The Syndicate Faction HQ never really finished, never put into real service or practice. More just a sort of prototype project. It's just a shame. I really wanted to see it in action. I really wanted to see it used as the HQ. It just took me so long to build because I think my eyes are too wide. Just had this vision of this enormous base. Never really got around to finishing it in time. And Elyon Studios, as always, just putting things out faster than we can actually deal with them. Anyway, I hope you guys can enjoy this base in some way. Even if you just spawn it in space and have a look around. But like I say, if you do manage to get it to spawn in, get some use out of it, do let me know. I'd be really interested to hear what you're able to do. But that is all. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you've enjoyed this episode and indeed the series on this one. I apologize for the slightly anticlimactic ending on this one. That unfortunately there's nothing we could really do. Elyon kind of forced our hand on that one. But anyway, thanks again. And hopefully I'll see you next time. Until then, take care. Bye-bye.